and Tata Motors. Now, if you see Maruti, the known fact is numbers were good. It has zoomed higher. It came back down to the same gap mode, and a reversal was seen today. Even after numbers were good, a selling pressure was seen in Maruti as well. So it opened gap up, and a continuous sell-off was seen in Maruti. I would suggest we would be buyer in Maruti at these lower levels, of course. But anywhere we find reversal prior to their results, we will look out for Maruti to buy along this range. Now, going and buying today, Maruti does not make any sense. People know numbers were good, it opened up, and now complete bearishness can be seen. Let it come down in this week or so, and if a downward rally starts in Nifty, it can also come towards 7,500 odd mark. Prior to the result, it will form a reversal pattern, and we will be buyer in Maruti. Let's see on the daily front. Even after a good result, posting of good numbers, it opens gap up. 5 minutes continuous selling. Another 5 minutes, it breaches the gap, fills the gap, goes below yesterday's close, yesterday's low. Everywhere it is trying to breach on the lower side. And actually, if I see the previous gap is also been completely filled by Maruti, right? So if initially people are bullish and entering into the counter with the long fresh trades, they have seen this kind of sell-off happening in Maruti, and might be many people are stuck over here now around this 8,000 mark or around this 7,920 mark. They might bring Maruti down so that the retail guys are out of this trade. So we will look out for Maruti. We are buyer in Maruti, but we will look out for these levels. If it reaches there, we will try to find reversal along these levels, and we'll buy Maruti.